Will Microsoft take Notion in the next year, and why will it do that? Let's dive into what the biggest threat for Notion is in the next year and how they can stop that innovation. So before we dive into today's video, we released an application called Bento. You can check it out in the link in the description. We also launched on the Product Hunt and we're in the top five. So do check out both of those below. So as you can imagine, Notion has been pretty fundamental in the last couple of years, changing the knowledge base experience for teams out there. And don't get me wrong, it's done an amazing job of innovating the space towards something that actually is a coherent way to manage yourself as a team, not just your knowledge, but also even your projects and databases and things that you would expect to be trapped in silos across loads of teams. And it's amassed a huge audience now, not just personal users, but teams globally are using this as their experience. And many of the other experiences, like Evernote, like Microsoft, have actually been sleeping on this market for a long time when they could have had a pretty decent piece of the pie. Now, the main reason I think Notion is going to come under threat is primarily because of Microsoft's technology that they're working on at the moment. Now, they're going to release something fairly soon called Microsoft Loop. Now, we've heard it be called through different names. It used to be called Fluid Framework, but now it's called Loop, and it's going to become a standalone application. And Microsoft, naturally, have seen this as a big market, and they've been sleeping on it for a long, long time now. So Loop is their opportunity to become a potential threat to Notion in the market. And I actually think the technology itself could potentially overtake Notion, primarily because the way that it's set up and the way that you can use it bypasses and leapfrogs the way that existing people are using Notion. Let me explain. Microsoft Loop, whilst it will come out with a standalone application, works inside of existing Microsoft apps like Microsoft Teams. A good example is, for example, you could be chatting with somebody at work and in real time within Teams without leaving it, you could be collaborating in real time on a document that lives outside of Microsoft Teams. Now, of course, many people know, you know, Google Docs, you could be working on that together, but you don't actually have to leave Teams. You can do it within the chat window. So there's so much potential, and that's why these Loop components are threatening to Notion's experience, because there are a lot of teams out there who have a Microsoft account that don't necessarily use its full capabilities, but they could just switch this Loop ability on and bypass their abilities with using Notion. And as you can imagine, when a team tends to like to have a comprehensive set of tools without having to switch across them, they want to be able to do that because it's naturally a lot easier to be able to do that. So there is a lot of merit in Loop components, and when Loop released their fully fledged application, which they are set to do in summer, not sure, like on a fixed date, but as you can imagine, that's going to change the market once again. So I think that this move by Microsoft Loop are almost leapfrogging Notion in a sense. Although Notion has done really well in the last couple of months, they've introduced themselves with sync databases, which is a really great feature. And I see a lot of team collaboration ability. It's almost like Loop components to some extent, because you don't have to do that sort of legwork that you would, for example, copying a Google Calendar into your Notion, it'd be able to populate itself. So those databases are a lot more powerful for teams. However, even though I do love those better databases and some of the other stuff they've been doing, I'm not sure it's enough for them to really take on Microsoft Loop head to head. I think as barefaced products, if they had Microsoft Loop versus Notion, Notion would win. However, because of Loop components, it takes them that step further and that edge further for many people looking to integrate and keep their systems simple in large teams. I definitely don't think Loop will threaten Notion's personal market, but as you can imagine, the majority of large money is made through team experiences. So that's why Notion want to go after this market and have adapted a lot of their marketing and presentation towards going towards teams. So, as you can imagine, a side note, Google Workspace is trying to do the same thing. I think they're trying to come after the Microsoft loop market. They're making things a lot easier to be able to do inside of one experience. So I think being able to use stuff more in Google Docs, I think that's going to become a lot more common in the next couple of months. But Notion do have a threat with Microsoft loop when we come to this summer. And I do think genuinely that teams might look at this as a solution to being able to integrate it over the top. Because whilst I do love Notion, I do think it's a great thing to support third-party applications and not big ones. I think that a lot of teams will see the value in not having to move applications. So folks, hopefully I would love your opinion in the comments below. Do you think Microsoft loop poses a big threat to Notion in the next year? It'd be amazing to hear your thoughts. If you want to check out Bento, I'll include the links in the description, and naturally you can use it and the methodology we've created to do less in your workday. Anyway, folks, hope you have a great day, and I'm looking forward to doing more of these videos. So if you did like this, feel free to comment below about what other topics you'd like me to cover. Anyway, folks, cheerio.